Okay, who? I actually said 2 minutes. I'm screwed. I stick to it. No, I say 2 minutes. And but before the 2 minutes starts, I just want to say happy birthday. And I know Manolis since a while. It all started at a poster discussion a couple, 10 years ago, something like this, and then I met a friendship. And I'm working in Christopher Mason Lab in Cornell, and I have many, many NASA projects, different kind of projects. So today I will be a little bit more different. Now, meaning of life. Meaning of life is actually with our human consciousness and with our intelligence and self-consciousness. Actually, it's so difficult to actually address this question. So let's simplify it a little bit. Let's see it's not as a human thing. Let's see it as a species. Human is a species. And what could be the meaning of life for all species on the world? It's so simple. It's survival. Survival is, for many species, actually the meaning of life. Survival by competition. Survival by adaptation and exploration. Adaptation, for example, my favorite bug of the world, outside on an ISS space station, we're able to survive radiation, like all the harsh conditions. I brought it back into the ISS station, thought, that can't be. Oh yeah, it was fine, oh, like, that's it, can't be. This is exciting and fascinating, but terrifying and frustrating, because that means we contaminated Mars and Moon since years. With human, with actually spores DNA. Spores can't survive space, we know that. So adaptation, but adaptation can't be always actually the solution for threats. For example, meteor could actually extinct a lot of species, including the human species. So what we have to go for, we have to look out. By statistics, we know that if we would mate to another station, like space station, or Mars, or Moon, and we build up just 100 people there, the human species would survive if the Earth got destroyed by meteor. So I think that's the meaning of life.